Good morning, everyone. This is Haralambos Pissouros, senior analyst at IronFX, bringing you the morning comment for the 21st of April. On Sunday, French citizens are called to elect their government leader, but the final outcome is unlikely to be sealed on that day. According to the opinion polls, there is no candidate gaining the absolute majority, so a second round between the two leading candidates is very likely to be held on the 7th of May. A couple of weeks ago, the leading candidates were three: Emmanuel Macron, Marine Le Pen, and François Fillon. Nevertheless, following a strong performance in the TV debates, left-wing candidate Jean-Luc Mélenchon enjoyed a stellar rise of support. His program displays a similar Eurosceptic stance to Le Pen's. He advocates for halting a Frexit referendum as well. Therefore, a runoff between him and Le Pen seems to be the biggest risk scenario for the financial world. If something like that takes flesh and bones, we expect the euro to sink as investors will likely price in a much greater risk of European disintegration. A general risk aversion mood is likely to dominate as well. Safe havens the yen are likely to benefit, while equity markets, especially European indices, could take the down road. The other side of the coin is a Macron-Fillon second round. In this case, the opposite market reaction may be observed, as this runoff combination may eliminate the risk for any Frexit referendum. However, at the moment, polls suggest that the most likely outcome is for Macron and Le Pen to make it to the second round, with the former winning by a large margin. In general, Macron is seen as the winner against any other of the candidates, so if Macron makes it on Sunday, this could cause a market relief and the common currency may open Monday with a gap up. In the less likely scenario of him being kicked out, the only combination that could be seen as relatively pro-risk is a Fillon-Le Pen runoff, given that polls give the final victory to Fillon. In a Fillon-Mélenchon race, Mélenchon is preferred. Euro-yen is one of the best proxies to play this election in our view. At the time, currently, the pair is trading near the support level of 1.17. We believe that due to the elections on Sunday, the pair may enjoy a quiet Friday session in the absence of any surprise news. If Sunday's combination favors a risk-averse mood in the financial community, the pair is possible to tumble and perhaps challenge the psychological territory of 1.15. On the other hand, a pro-risk result could cause the pair to rally and break the downtrend line taken from the peak of the 13th of March. This could be the trigger for a short-term trend reversal. Of course, much will depend on who gets the first place in the aforementioned combinations and by how much margin. As for today's events, during the European morning, we get the preliminary market manufacturing and services PMIs for April from several European nations and the Eurozone as a whole. Given that investors are likely to be on the edge of their seats for Sunday's outcome, we don't expect a major euro reaction from these releases. In the UK, retail sales are forecast to have fallen somewhat in March, which could cause the pound to erase some of the gains it posted after Prime Minister Theresa May called for snap elections. From Canada, we get CPI data for March. Expectations are for the headline rate to have declined somewhat, while no forecast is available for the core rate. The nation's market manufacturing PMI for the month indicated that manufacturers raised the prices of final products at the steepest rate in 3 years. So although temporary factors may have dragged down the headline rate, the core rate may have remained unchanged or even ticked up, which could prove positive for the Canadian dollar. Dollar CAD could correct back below the 134.55 support and perhaps challenge as a support the prior downside resistance line taken from the peak of the 9th of March. From the US, we get the preliminary market manufacturing and services PMIs for April and existing home sales for March. We have several speakers at the G20 meeting and the IMF or World Bank conference, including ECB President Mario Draghi and ECB board member Benoit Aguirre. For more information, please read the full comment on aerorfx.com or download our app and get all the information you need to trade. Also, you can follow us on Twitter, like us on Facebook, subscribe to our YouTube channel, or circle us on Google Plus to get more trading ideas. This is Harlambos Bissouros, senior analyst at AeronFX, wishing you solid trading.